We have already looked at how to layer loops, but what if you want the loops to sound more unique? Well, you can customize them. Let's start by going into the EDM starter kit and drag in a drum loop. I want to create a classic EDM buildup at the end here. To do so, I need to cut it into smaller pieces. How do you cut something? With scissors, of course. Click the scissor tool over here, and then you can cut the loop wherever you want. I'll cut out this part with the kick. Switch back to the pointer tool, select what you don't want to keep, and hit delete on your keyboard. Loop this bit to create a stutter effect. Now I'll copy the loop over by pressing Alt while dragging. You can trim it down by dragging in the lower corner and then loop it out to the end. Now we have created a nice buildup. Let's chop up some vocals now. I'll use this vocal chop loop, but I'm going to chop it up my way. Like before, select the scissor tool and cut out the parts you like. Switch back to the pointer tool, delete the scraps, and arrange the clips however you want. There we go, and let's copy this over. In our How to Layer Drum Loops tutorial, we mentioned that all loops need to be in the same tempo. What we didn't mention is that you can take loops in different tempos and stretch them to fit together. Let's go to a starter kit with a different tempo. I'll choose a percussion loop. If I play this now, you'll notice that it sounds weird. The easiest way to make a loop fit the project's tempo is to right-click on the clip and choose Time Stretch, or Pitch to Fit Song Tempo. This will automatically stretch the loop for you. Time Stretch will try to keep the loop's key, and Pitch Stretch will change the key but has better sound quality. I'm going to go for Pitch. And now it's perfectly in sync. You can also use Pitch Stretch as an effect. Let's go back to the EDM starter kit and find a piano loop to manipulate. I want to slow it down and pitch it down to make it more lo-fi and mellow. To do this, go to the stretch tool over here and choose Pitch Stretch. This tool will let you change the speed of the loop manually by dragging the lower corner. If you drag it inward, it will speed it up and pitch it up. If you drag it outward, it will slow it down and pitch it down. Since this loop was already in the right tempo and key, changing it like this will mess it up. But if you change the clip to half or double the size, the tempo and key will sync up again. The last thing I want to show you is how to make a loop play in reverse. It's a handy trick to get swelling and trippy sounds. Let's just take the same piano loop, right-click on it, and choose Reverse Clip. It's that simple. These were just a few ideas on how you can customize your loops. You can also shape the sound of them with effects, but we will cover that in a future tutorial.